Did you know that you can have a huge impact in open source even without coding new features or fixing bugs? Let's get rid of this misconception, because there are many other ways that are a lot beneficial to open source, and you should do them regularly. Hi, I'm Leonardo, and in this video I'm going to move the spotlight to give some more visibility to those core activities that make open source projects successful even without writing a single line of code. I'm going to split these activities in 6 categories and give for each of them a practical example. The categories are documentation, management, design, awareness, code-related, and non-software. Documentation. The name is pretty much self-explanatory, but this is really often overlooked. Let's say you want to run a project, but you have no idea how to do that on your machine. You really hope there's a contributing.md file in the repository with the instruction on how to do that. Without that piece of documentation, you wouldn't even be able to run the project. Do you get how important that is? If you spot a project with outdated or even missing documentation, for example, on how to launch the application, how the architecture is, or the UI, well, there's a huge gap to fill. Writing up some docs will boost the project and help everyone else contributing to it. But there's even more! You can, for example, write blog posts, articles, record YouTube videos to even further generate content for the community and the other contributors. Don't forget that answering questions on Stack Overflow can be considered documentation as well. Imagine someone, or even yourself, googling for a question and finding the answer on Stack Overflow. You not only helped the guy who asked the question, but also everyone else finding that answer in the future. These count as a contribution as well. You can also translate documentation that is already existing into your own language or languages you know. This might help someone who's not really fluent with English. Next up we have management. Open source project has some kind of project management as well, usually on the shoulders of owner and maintainers of the project itself. But if you're kind of an organized person, you can help as well. For example, you can link duplicate issues, asking for more details for bug reports, reproducing bugs, or even adding more context. A collateral way of contributing is raising awareness to the project. If you have deep knowledge of a particular project and you like public speaking, you might consider organizing workshops and meetups talking about the project itself. Don't forget that the more visibility a project gets, the more contributors might attract, and you can contribute to it. Do you know a really easy way to raise awareness to open source projects in general? Well, hit like on this video and subscribe to my channel. I post regularly videos about open source, and by helping me, you're also helping the open source community. Thank you! Are you good with diagrams? The next category is design. This can be intended as a visual medium of documentation. Complex structures or flows often require some visualization.
Visualization
to be understood. You can consider creating structured UML or flowchart to properly explain and document those flows. You can see some examples in the VS Code repository where they show with a simple diagram their core architecture or how they manage multi-target environment. Code related. Let's talk about code. I know you'll like it, but it's not but fixes or feature requests. Code reviews are always welcome. You can jump in, do your review, write a comment, and help someone. Don't forget to be polite and respectful of the other developers when doing code reviews. But constructive feedback is always well appreciated. They'll be grateful at you. If you really want to write code, you can think about some internal tools, for example, for quickly start up and install the application itself. You can also improve the tests, improve the coverage, and make that debugging environment local easier and quicker. In general, code that is going to help the other contributors in doing their job, and also to be more productive and safe. The last category for today is not only software. If you think that GitHub is only a place where you can find code, you'll be really surprised by what I'm going to say. There are many repositories focused on collecting information, not only for developers, but for everyone, and they're open source. You can find many of them under Explore, Topics, Awesome Lists. As you can read, there are lists for a plethora of different topics, and there's a list serving as an index in organized categories. There are repos about books, gaming, business, networking, all kind of stuff. Contributing to those lists still counting as contributing to open source. And with this last one, we cover all categories. As you can see, there are so many ways to contribute to open source. Did you know all of them? If you want to add something, just write a comment. Once again, my name is Leonardo and I post video about open source and web development. Thank you for watching. Follow me if you're interested in new content and see you soon.